Savipra, for giving me this opportunity. Actually, I come from a little different background. I'm a clinician and working with Indian Council of Medical Research. So although in various in government system for various rules and regulations for recruitments, we do have certain guidelines where we consider that women should be protected, I mean, having a mandatory membership and other things. But besides that, this is my first exposure to this group and this discussion. So actually, it's science of women in science. So since I come from Indian Council of Medical Research, just to give you in brief, that Indian Council of Medical Research, situated in New Delhi, has 26 institutes all over India with many field stations. And recently, this was the coffee table book, which was released. And you know, I don't know whether this we say is good or bad. ICMR gets a second woman head in 100-year history. This was a caption in some article published. But although ICMR, it per se may not be 100-year-old, it was association earlier, but I just counted out of 12 director generals, now we had two women director generals. But the positive side of story is the director general we had recently, she has gone to a very high position in international organization in WHO. So you can see, I mean, of course we say that there have been women in very senior position, but too few. If we say the institutes of ICMR, there are many institutes, there will be a little bit changed now because of merger and all, but most of them, they had, I mean, the women have been very, number is around 30% or so, except two in Mumbai, we can see here, and one institute in Delhi. So otherwise, most of the institutes are, women are about 20 to 30%, if we say science faculty as well as, and if we talk about the directors, I think it's 5 or 6 direct, that also comes to 28% out of all the institutes in the highest position. So this is a general trend which we see. Actually, I'm proud to be coming from a only women medical school, which are very few, I think, globally. So there also, but in the medical background, we see a divide, like you have been talking in science, that in some specializations, preclinical, paraclinical, or like gynecology, their number of women may be more, rather 90%. But in other specializations, the number is very low. But yes, a lot of women, unlike IITs, are qualifying the medical examinations, but I don't know definite statistics. But there are many women colleges for other graduation and post-graduation, but for medicine, there are very few. Now, there have been, of course, Indian women in science and technology, and in ancient India, I mean, we just talked in the morning, Leelavati, a mathematician and astrologist, and in pre-independence era also, we know Kadambini Ganguly, who was first female graduate of British Empire, Anandi Joshi, first Indian to study medicine from abroad, Annamani, physicist, and Rajeshwari Chatterjee. And also post-independence era, just I'm naming few, Indra Induja has been associated with IVF first test tube baby, and with ICMR there have been activity. And of course, Kiran Majumdar, Aditi Pant, Suman Sahai, Kalpana Chawla, of course, these are some of the names which should encourage us that the lot has happened. And there have been many schemes and many activities, and this is the calendar which highlighted important women. So these are some of the things which have been taken up in different forums. And like in, although over the period there has been a growth of women with access to education as far as India is concerned, but again here you see like in agriculture or in veterinary sciences, the number has been very low. So it depends, and even in engineering, it's not as, like biological sciences, as has been told in the morning, has the highest number. And in various organizations, again, this is data from 2004 and 2008. Actually, I have taken for most of the published documents, and you are all pioneers in that. So as I said, I did not have much background on this subject, but then I looked into these documents, really interesting information. But overall, if we see not much change over the last few years, maybe from the earlier there has been some bit of change, but generally the figures vary between 20 to 30% wherever we say. And many organizations, and like UN organizations, say there should be minimum 30% of women for recruitment. I don't know why 30% only, although otherwise it should be 50%. Now, where we are missing, although it has been discussed in the morning, like in the earlier, like when it is bachelor's or schooling or initial part of the studies, there are women, like in 51% in bachelor's, if we talk about India. But overall, when they go to higher studies or postdocs or end at a higher levels of positions, there are the pipeline, as we say, is really leaky. And when it comes to female researchers, here we are saying at the later level of their studies or research, it's like goes down from 53 to 28%. So this is a worldwide picture. But even in India, you see from 51% to 28%. But in India, the situation is a bit different. I mean, it starts from the very beginning. I'll just talk about it later. But if there is a study from UNESCO, I mean, where the dropout from bachelor to PhD, where for that matter, India had the lowest dropout. But then later on, when PhD to researcher, India has a very high dropout rate. Now, in India, there is a problem of unique to India. One thing is that we hear about other issues like feticide. Right from the very beginning, there are issues. There is skewed sex ratio. And then, of course, the pipeline is really heavily leaky. And there is a male bias, psycho-socio-cultural aspects are there. And also, definitely, I think women scientists has to take up many roles. That is true for many countries, but in India, it more so. It is the women who is considered to take up those roles. And then, of course, there is diversity. And as far as India is concerned, I mean, these figures or ratios vary from state to state. It's not that in whole country, the importance of this information is that if you take any measures, it may not be same applicable universally to whole India. There are really great variations within different states of India. So I come to women. So workplace climate, of course, is important. And that can be many things, like whether it is leave rules, childcare, flexi time, or to preventing harassment. Opportunities, of course, I'll mention a few. Women-centric schemes are there, then representation, compulsory representation in selection committees, in councils has to be there. And then, of course, to retain, we need mentoring. And of course, show them the role models and incentives. And of course, re-entry. Many schemes are there for that. But still, a lot more to be done. Encouragement, of course. There can be many ways of encouragement, scholarship. Or, I read in some article, the promotional avenues may be different. If there is a leave period, that may not be considered as gone, or the number of publications may be considered more as compared to the male counterparts. I don't know the implications of those, but these are some of the things which can be taken up for encouragement. And for neutrality in gender, of course, gender-neutral roles and gender sensitization. So, as I said, there are many schemes. I won't go into details, like this, and the good acronyms, Disha, Kiran, some of them by DST, DBT, and Curie, postdoctoral scholarships, biotechnology, career advancements, and this biocare programs of DBT. And in fact, we have taken many scientists with break in career. DST has a very good scheme for that. And then, of course, there are encouragement, women excellence awards. ICMR has long-term training fellowships to women with the break in their career. And then, of course, as I said, DST has a lot of these schemes. And of course, there is a Golden Jubilee Biotech Park for women. So these are some of the initiatives which have been taken up. And of course, there is a dedicated web page. You must all be aware of that. Gives me a lot of information. I tried to go through this. So at the end, I would like to say that it is, I don't know, maybe it's a different viewpoint. Like, as far as Indian aspect is concerned, there are a lot of more, much more issues than women being in science or in the higher positions. There are other social aspects which need to be taken care of. And because of the diversity, we need to have a specific issue related to women in different socioeconomic groups or maybe in residing in different areas. But my thinking is that if we have only we consider women-centric schemes or empowering women for various issues, because many of the issues are related to family, bringing up children, taking care of parents, old parents. So in that case, even if there are some things which are for men, naturally, it will help women to, share the responsibility. Like for that matter, there are some organizations that are very child-friendly. And you can see here, actually, it's a secret. It happens to be my grandchild's photograph. So if these are organizations, they say, bring your child to work. If a husband is in that type of organization, definitely it will give some space to the wife to take care of her own responsibility. So, of course, then we are saying that child care facilities in where mother is working. In initial part, definitely, physiologically, it is more important for mother. When we give leave only for women, it means it is only their responsibility to look after the family and child. And then in that respect, I have seen my own students, they suffer more because they half the year, if they are not able to come, it is their career which is being affected. And family says, yes, you have this leave, you take care of the child. So those are the things, I don't know, I may be correct or wrong, but those are the things we have to take comprehensively. Wherever it is needed, yes, we try to keep them, retain them, mentor them, encourage them. But when it comes to the later part to support a family, I think the schemes have to be looking at both the partners. Thank you very much.